Friends, in this video we are going to see kinematics of fluid flow. So kinematics of fluid flow, chapter 5. So what is kinematics? I want to tell you, kinematics is the branch of science which deals with the motion of the fluid particles without considering the forces causing the motion. That means in this topic kinematics, we are not going to consider the forces because of which there is a motion in the fluid particle, but we are only interested in finding the motion of the fluid particles, that is velocity and acceleration. So as you can see in the figure here, so there's a fluid mass which is rotating, right? There's a fluid mass having a different pattern here, circular pattern. So this diagram is showing you the even the fluid mass can rotate, can go for a circular motion. And in the second figure, this is the streamline actually. What is streamline? A streamline is an imaginary path drawn in a flow field such that tangent drawn to it at any point gives you the direction of velocity vector at that point. Correct. So these three are the streamlines. And ABCD, this is a fluid particle. This is a fluid particle actually. So whatever be the path followed by the fluid particle, that can be called as streamline, provided the condition is steady flow fluid particle. So once again, I want to tell you the definition of streamline. First of all, it is an imaginary line drawn in any flow field such that tangent drawn to it at any point gives you the direction of velocity vector at that point. That means each and every point in the streamline is capable of giving you the direction of velocity vector, correct? And ABCD is a fluid particle which is moving in this direction. You can see arrow marks direction is given here. Let's go to the next slide. Introduction. So kinematics introduction, as I told you, kinematics is the branch of science which deals with the motion of the fluid particles. Motion of the fluid particle without considering the forces. Very, very important line, without considering the forces causing the motion. There are two main approaches to the study of motion of the fluid particle. One is Lagrangian method and second one is Eulerian method. Let's go and see the detail. What are the two different approaches for finding the motion of the fluid particle in the next slide. Lagrangian method. So in this method, actually, a single fluid particle is followed during its course of motion. Why the single fluid particle is followed? To find the properties like the velocity, acceleration, and other properties. So, look at this box here. We fix our attention to an individual particle. Right? When you say individual, you can also say single fluid particle. Individual particle during a fluid flow and note the characteristic like the velocity, acceleration, etc. V is a vector quantity, acceleration is also a vector quantity. And so what it represents in the Lagrangian approach, you can see in this diagram, this green color circle is a fluid particle, right? So these are the fluid particles following this path actually, correct? So what happens if you want to know the property or characteristic, you have to follow this single fluid particle during this course of motion. Look at this first point. It refers to the description of the behavior of individual fluid particle. This is very important. Individual or single fluid particle during their course of motion. The observer travels with the particle being studied. So if you want to know the characteristic of single particle, you have to follow with the, you have to follow the particle. That means you have to keep on moving behind the particle to know what is the exact velocity and acceleration at any particular moment. Third point is the fluid velocity and acceleration are then determined as a function of position and time. So why we are following? We are following so that we can know what is the exact velocity and time, and that can be a function of position, that is coordinate x, y, z and time t. Everything is a function of time, you know that. So the observer travels with the particle being studied. So this is very difficult part, correct? You have to always follow a particle in order to know the characteristic. So in order to overcome this problem, we are having Eulerian approach. So just remember that in Lagrangian method, a single fluid particle is followed during the entire course of motion to know the characteristic of a particle. Okay. Now let's go into the second one, Eulerian approach. Second one is here, Eulerian approach. In this method, we are fixing our frame at a particular point or a section, you can say, in a space during a fluid flow and noting the characteristic of particles as they pass through the frame. The moment they pass through the frame is very important, or you can say a section. So at any point, at any section, we are putting a frame and we are just observing what happens, what are the particles moving and what is their characteristic, like velocity, acceleration. It is just like, very good example I'm giving you so that you can understand. It is just like a traffic signal. So on the traffic signal, you are installing a camera, right? You're installing a camera. Traffic signal is a point and you're installing a camera and you're observing what happens or what is going on the signal, how many number of cars passing, how many, or who is violating the rules, traffic rules, like this. So it is just like at any point you're putting a frame and then observing what is happening, correct? So here attention is focused on the motion and properties of different fluid particles, correct? So different fluid particle means by sitting at one point, definitely by sitting at one point, you can observe different persons, whether they are violating or whether they are following the traffic rules. Same way, different fluid particles can be followed. Different fluid particles can be followed as they pass fixed point in space. As they pass fixed point in space, the observer remains stationary. Yeah, this is very important. No need to follow this particle. Okay, the observer remains stationary and observe that what happens at some particular point. Correct? At some particular point means at some particular section also, you can say. Okay, so this is all about your introduction, Eulerian and Lagrangian method for approach of motion. Okay, thank you.